गुड इवनिंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मेथड ऑफ वेरिएशन ऑफ पैरामीटर्स। इन द प्रीवियस डिस्कशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद स्पेशल फॉर्म ऑफ फंक्शंस व्हिच कैन नॉट बी सॉल्व्ड व्हिच कैन बी सॉल्व्ड बाय अर्लियर मेथड्स, बट many differential equations which cannot be solved by the earlier method can be solved by this method. So working procedure for variation of parameters method: star 1 denotes first step. Given fd of y equals to pi of x, we write cf means complementary function in the form of c1 y1 plus c2 y2 is equals to yc, where y1 and y2 are independent solutions of the given differential equation. Now step 2, assuming y equals to a y1 plus b y2, where a and b are to be determined later, equation 2 be the complete solution of given differential equation. Step 3, computing y1 dash and y2 dash and finding the Wronskian w equals to y1 y2 dash minus y2 y1 dash. Step 4, we have formula a dash equals to minus y2 into pi of x divided by Wronskian and b dash equals to y1 pi of x divided by Wronskian. By applying integration, we got a equals to integration of minus y to pi of x divided by Wronskian with respect to dx plus c1, b equals to integration of y1 pi of x divided by Wronskian with respect to x plus c2. Step 5, substituting these a and b in the equation 2 above, we call y equals to a y1 plus b y2 will be the general solution or complete solution of the given differential equation. These are the working processes to compute the variation of parameter method. Let me go through one example. Solve by the method of variation of parameters y double dash plus a square y is equals to sec ax. This is the second order differential equation. We have d square plus a square into bracket y equals to sec ax. To find out complementary function, we consider given differential equation as homogeneous by writing d square plus a square into y equals to 0, whose auxiliary equation is m square plus a square equals to 0. So later I am writing m square equals to minus of a square. Then m is plus or minus ia. So we found m equals to plus or minus ia. I is a imaginary. So we got m equals to plus or minus ia is a complex root. For this we are writing yc equals to c1 cos ax plus c2 sin ax. Let me call it as equation number 1, which is the complementary function of homogeneous differential equation. Now step 2, assuming y equals to a into y1 plus b into y2 be the complete solution, where y1 is cos x, y2 is sin ax. Okay, now we have to find y1 dash and y2 dash from the known y1 and y2, where y1 and y2 are y1 is cos x, y2 is sin x. Differentiation of cos x is minus a into sin x. Differentiation of sin ax is a into cos ax. Then computing y1 y2 dash, this into this minus this into this. So y1 y2 dash minus y2 dash, we will get w equals to a, which is called as Wronskian. So Wronskian will be a. Now I have defined in the processor, we have a formula a equals to integration minus y2 pi of x divided by Wronskian plus c1, b equals to integration y1 pi of x divided by w plus C2. So substituting the values here, where we have known values, y2 is sin x, y1 is cos x, and pi of x is sec x, and Wronskian is w. Using these three factors, let me repeat, pi of x is sec x, which is the RHS of given equation, y1 and y2 are the independent solutions of complementary function, and Wronskian is a. Now a equals to integration sin x into sec x divided by a, b equals to integration cos x into sec x divided by a plus c2. We have to integrate this with respect to x to find out a and b. So here a equals to integration sin into sec. Sec can be written as 1 by cos, and here we have sine. So sine by cos will be always tan. This is the trigonometric ratio. Sine by cos is tan. So we have used sine by cos as tan. So here I got minus tan ax by a into dx plus c1. Integration of tan ax is log sec ax by a, and we got log sec ax divided by a square plus c1 as a. Similarly, b we got cos x into sec x. Sec x can be written as 1 by cos. Again into cos, get cancelled. We got only 1. So here I have written 1 by a dx plus c2, which is integration of dx is x and with constant x by a plus c2. So we got both a and b. Using this a and b in equation 2 above, where we have written y equals to ay1 plus by2, where y1 is cos x, y2 is sin x, substituting this a and b. So we got this as a complete solution. To rectify it, let me multiply this cos with this function. We got cos with c1, sin with c2, and x by sin. So here we got c1 cos x, c2 sin x. Just for check verification purpose, let me go for previous discussion where I have written yc is a c1 cos x plus c2 sin x. Let me check whether we got the same answer or not. C1 cos x plus c2 sin x. So here we got c1 cos x plus c2 sin x is a complementary function. And remaining terms, what we got, minus log sec ax into cos ax divided by a square plus x by a sin ax is pi. Just for understanding purpose, I am writing this as pi, this as cf. But finally, we should write a complementary solution. Complete solution of the given differential equation is like this. This is the process of finding second order differential equation by using process of method of variation of parameters. Here are the few assignment questions 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Please go through the notes once again. If you have any doubts, you are free to discuss with me. Thank you very much.